of investors right now are trying to understand what the world will look like for companies like your own that have both benefited on some parts of their business from the pandemic, frankly, and also obviously been held back. HVAC, North American Residential, for example, up 25%, a great business for you over this last year. How do you see it in terms of things that will perhaps go back to a more normalized growth rate and things that will benefit once we get back closer to normal?
Well, good morning, David. We really view 2021 as kind of a tale of two halves. The things that have been strong, we come in with very, very strong backlog. Things like you mentioned, residential HVAC, where we had our best half in our company's history. Third quarter up almost 50%, fourth quarter up 25%. The backlog is up 3x over what it was at the same time last year coming into the year. And January orders have been very strong. So we continue to see what's strong will continue to be strong in the first half. And then what we're banking on is the things that have been acutely challenged during the pandemic, things like our light commercial business, which is tied to retail, other parts tied to hospitality. As the vaccine gets out, we are expecting a recovery of those businesses in the second half of the year.
So the backlog carries you through the first half, and then you get to a second half where you start to see orders pick up for what you just talked about in terms of retail stores and just commercial spaces?
That's exactly right, David. And, you know, what's nice is that at Carrier, we find ourselves really at the intersection of three really critical societal needs. You know, people are paying more attention to indoor air quality, and that's what we do. A huge focus on sustainability with the current administration. You saw Larry Fink's letter. So a lot of focus on sustainability. That's what we do. And then with the cold chain and the vaccine distribution, that's what we do. So we find ourselves at the intersection of these three societal needs. And we think that'll provide some lift in our growth and our earnings in 21.
Why the decision to start buying back stock, particularly given the incredible performance you've had? Some might argue, you know, you may be buying it back a little bit higher than you might otherwise want to.
You know, honestly, we're buying it back a little bit at the margin. It gives us a bit of 1 cent offset to a 3 cent tailwind from the that we're seeing because of the accretion. So, you know, we're only talking about $250 million of share buyback. Our big focus is going to be on growth. So you'll see more investments in organic growth. We've now positioned ourselves for bolt-on M&A. We've really done a phenomenal job with the balance sheet. When we spun from UTC, we had $10 billion of net debt. We ended with $7 billion of net debt. By the end of this year, it should be closer to six. We sit on $3 billion of cash. We increased our dividend by 50% in 21 over 2020. So a little bit of share buyback, but a lot of focus on dividends and growth.
Theo, the growth in refrigeration orders, how much of that is vaccine rollout? And if a lot of it is, how much does that continue now that a lot of that infrastructure is in place?
You know, we'll see great growth in our refrigeration business. The reality is the lion's share of that is really a cyclical recovery. You know, if you look at our truck trailer business in North America, for example, this year should be up about 40% over last year. The lion's share due to a cyclical recovery, but we are seeing more orders and more pent-up demand for things like vaccine distribution and food distribution. So we have one business that does cargo monitoring that is really directly tied to the vaccine distribution. Sales there were up 10%. Our backlog going into this year is up 170% in that business. And we are seeing more excitement for the Lynx offering that we've established with AWS, which is really about data. And what you really need for effective vaccine distribution, when you have all the multiple players in the system, all the multiple handoffs, is one central data repository, and then using AI and ML to really improve the effectiveness of that distribution. So that's what we're particularly leaning into there.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.